Hello friends, welcome to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back with two SpaceX updates for you. We're going to start with a breaking news, as the news that could have been a disaster for SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has now taken a dramatic turn. In the last few months, there have been much speculation regarding debris from the abandoned SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket being on a collision course with the moon, resulting in what would be the first known case of a human-made object unintentionally striking against a celestial body. Space debris and space traffic have become very real threats to humanity in the last few years, and Elon Musk's SpaceX has been facing considerable backlash for its contribution to it. Now, there have been some new developments in the moon collision story. In January of this year, astronomer Bill Gray announced that the upper stage of the SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket would collide with the moon in early March. Predictably, the prediction sparked numerous press releases, many of which were critical of Elon Musk and his personal space company. Ultimately, this could have been a disastrous news for SpaceX. However, Elon and the party did not seem to lose anything. Rather, fate is more likely to befall China. That's because Gray made a mistake of first identifying a piece of space junk, which he and other astronomers named WE0913A in 2015. When Gray and his colleagues first spotted the object, several clues led them to believe it was the second stage of a Falcon 9 rocket that had carried the Atmospheric Administration's Discover satellite and National Oceanic entered deep orbit the same year. The identification of the object would probably not have been covered in the mainstream media if astronomers had not later discovered that it was about to collide with the moon. Gray said in a blog post he published on Saturday that, "Back in 2015, I misidentified this object as 2015-007B, the second stage of the Discover spacecraft. I had pretty good circumstantial evidence for the identification, but nothing conclusive." Gray further said, "That was not at all unusual. Identifications of high-flying space junk often require a bit of detective work, and sometimes we never do figure out the ID for a bit of space junk." Prompted by John's email, I dug into my email archives to remind myself why I had originally identified the object as the Discover stage in the first place, 7 years ago. I did that digging in full confidence that it would prove that the object was, in fact, the Discover second stage, Gray wrote in his update. Gray also added, "Shortly thereafter, an astronomer in Brazil noted on a news group that the object was orbiting the Earth, not the Sun, suggesting it might be a human-made object. And others came to accept the identification with the second stage of Falcon 9 as correct. The object had about the brightness we would expect, and had showed up at the expected time and moving in a reasonable orbit," Gray continued. "I should have noticed some odd things about WE0913's orbit. Assuming no maneuvers, it would have been in a somewhat odd orbit around the Earth before the lunar flyby. At its highest point, it would be near the moon's orbit, at its lowest, perigee, about a third of that distance. I'd have expected the perigee to be near the Earth's surface. The perigee seemed quite high. If it wasn't for John Giorgini, NASA Jet Propulsion Lab engineer, we would never have known the true identity of the debris." He contacted Gray on Saturday to confirm his identity. NASA's Horizon system, a database that can estimate the positions and orbits of nearly 500,000 celestial bodies in our solar system, showed that the Discover spacecraft's trajectories did not come close to the moon, Giorgini said. "Therefore, it's unusual for a second step to go out of path and hit a satellite." Giorgini's email prompted Gray to reconsider the data it used for initial identification. Gray now says he's reasonably certain the rocket that's about to collide with the moon belongs to China. In October 2014, the country's space agency launched its Chang 5T1 mission on a Long March 3C rocket. After reconstructing the probable trajectory of that mission, he found that the Long March 3C is the best fit for the mystery object that's about to hit Earth's natural satellite. Running the orbit back to launch for the Chinese spacecraft makes ample sense, he told The Verge. It winds up with an orbit that goes past the moon at the right time after launch. And after the news of Discover possibly colliding with the moon began to circulate, the media was ruthless when it came to criticizing SpaceX for failing to properly dispose of the second stage of its Falcon 9 rocket after the launch of Discover in 2015. In fact, even the European Space Agency commented on the matter, expressing that it takes care to preserve enough fuel to put spent rocket stages into stable orbits around the Sun. But now that Bill Gray's statements suggest that it was China that may have been remiss in discarding its spacecraft, the tables have turned in SpaceX's favor, and how. So let's wait and watch if the same amount of criticism that was thrown Musk's way will be directed at the China National Space Administration. Now let's look into another update, and that too regarding Starship. In the recent Starbase development, SpaceX has finally commenced the filling up the propellant tanks at orbital launch site with methane. SpaceX has begun the filling and testing of their orbital tank farm for the last 5 months, and recently they've started filling the propellant part of the tanks. On the 13th of February, SpaceX has finally begun filling the already installed tanks with methane while they also work to expand the methane farm. In the first propellant delivery, Starbase got 3 truckloads of refrigerated methane. Since late September 2021, SpaceX's Starbase have started receiving deliveries of liquid nitrogen and liquid oxygen in vast quantity. Within a month, they partially filled up one of the farm's 7 cryogenic tanks. Deliveries of liquid nitrogen were followed by deliveries of liquid oxygen. The first liquid oxygen was delivered almost a couple of weeks after one tank was partially filled with nitrogen. After the main tank farm structure was completed, it was expected that SpaceX will go for cryoproof test and then filling of liquid methane tanks. But it didn't happen. By October 2021, the second vertical methane tank of the tank farm was installed. By early December, the sleeving of the tanks was completed. In the meantime, 2 more horizontal methane tanks were installed. By December 2021, SpaceX teams have started cryoproof testing of the methane tanks. But there was sluggish development in terms of the methane part. Sources state that SpaceX's placing of vertical methane storage tanks was not meeting the rules of Texas regulations for storing methane. In terms of horizontal space between tanks, retaining walls, wiring, and plumbing, vertical methane tanks seems to have violated the rules. It's expected that slow growth in methane part of tank farm may happen due to these violations. Thus, the vertical methane tanks were not totally completed for pouring in fuel. SpaceX then mainly gave attention for completion of horizontal tanks. According to some reports, while the vertical tanks can store 1,800 cubic meters of liquid methane, the horizontal tanks can hold at least 1,000 cubic meters each. If SpaceX goes for replacing all the vertical tanks with horizontal ones, then they have to install 2 more horizontal tanks, in addition to the 2 tanks already installed, to equate the storage capacity. Almost 4/5 part of Starship and Super Heavy can be fueled presently with the help of these 2 horizontal methane tanks. If SpaceX maintains the same speed for delivery of methane, just as the liquid nitrogen and liquid oxygen deliveries, then those 2 horizontal tanks could be completely filled by the end of this month. After storing a good quantity of liquid methane, it's expected that SpaceX go for wet dress rehearsals of stacked Starship and Super Heavy. SpaceX teams may also carry out the full static fire test of Booster 4, paving the way for orbital launch in near future. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.